Welcome back, everyone. This is MJ with MinIO. In this installation video, we're actually going to install Krew on our lab server. Krew is a package manager for kubectl plugins. So there's lots of great plugins out there. I highly recommend that you go and check out the Krew repo and see all of the different plugins that you could add to your system to enhance your Kubernetes experience. And Krew allows for the easy installation of kubectl plugins. You can install Krew by following the instructions at this link, also in the description below. The installation is mildly complex because you do have to run this somewhat convoluted command here, but you can simply copy and paste it from the website and then append this to your bash rc file and restart your shell. And once you do that, then kubectl Krew will be available to you in the system. So let's jump over and look at the docs for this real quick. So here we are on the docs page for Krew. You'll note that it gives you a number of different options. So if you are running a different shell other than bash, maybe you're running ZSH or something, then you should be able to install this in there as well. But as I said before, you just need to copy this command right here and make sure that Git is installed on your system. It comes installed by default on Ubuntu, but that may be different for the system that you're running this on. And you'll copy this and run this as a command. And then the next thing you need to do is to add this path into your bash rc, or if you're running ZSH, your ZSH rc file, and then restart your shell and kubectl Krew will be available to you. Let's take a look at the install in our lab environment. So here we are in our lab environment. We're going to go ahead and run that block of code to actually get Krew installed. So go ahead and paste that in there. And you'll note that it's going to do a few different things. It's going to download from the GitHub repo the Krew plugin and then install it on your system. The next piece that you need to do is you need to add the Krew path to your bash rc file. So we'll do nano bash rc. And I typically just put this at the bottom of the file. So we'll go down to the bottom, add a space, and paste that in. We're exporting the path to that Krew environment into the path for your system. So we'll go ahead and save this. And now if we restart our shell by running bash and run kubectl Krew, we can see that Krew is working and it gives us a number of different options for working with Krew. You can install a certain plugin, you can list all the plugins available, and a number of other things in here. So that's the basics of installing kubectl Krew on your system. In the next video, we will move on to some of the other prerequisites you need for the lab environment in order to get MinIO up and running in Kubernetes. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.